year old man, this is just an example. They can ask you with any age group because it can be seen in any age group. It will present as multiple small hypopigmented macules. Mind it that it can present even as hyperpigmented macules also. The sites most common are chest and back. The macules are arranged circular around the follicles and they can coalesce to form large sheets. They are associated with fine scaling. The most appropriate investigation to confirm the diagnosis is KOH preparation of the scales. This has been dealt in quite a bit detailed way in fungal infections topic, the video of which I will put it in the I button here. You can watch it. And the next most important topic in pigmentary disorders is vitreous alba. This is the next favorite question of the examiner, where they can mention a 5-year-old boy, 7-year-old boy, 5-year-old boy. I don't know why they are very much interested in boys, but this can be even seen in girls also. They will mention that small hyperpigmented scaly macule is present over the cheek. They will mention classmates are also having similar lesions. P. alba is a recurrent kind of lesion. So, in this condition, no active treatment is required. It's a benign condition, commonly seen over the face, presents a scaly whitish macules. That is about vitreous alba. Coming to piebaldism, it is an autosomal dominant disorder. It is an emelanotic skin associated with whitish forelock. There will be islands of normal or even hyperpigmented skin present. Remember, piebaldism does not improve with age. Few books have given this as a wrong answer. You just note this point. Causes of hypopigmentation. Certain diseases which are associated with hyperpigmentation are nevus animicus, scleroderma or systemic sclerosis, leprosy Hansen's disease, pinta, syphilis and pitresis versicola. I have discussed leprosy in detail. I will give the link to the video in the iCard. Even I have discussed syphilis in detail. I will put the link in the iCard. You can check the videos. An increased incidence of vitiligo is found in diabetic patients. Most common endocrine disturbance associated with vitiligo is thyroid disease. So if you become a dermatologist in the future and a vitiligo patient comes to you, then the first and most important investigation to rule out endocrine disturbances is to send the patient T3, T4, TSH. And also anti-TPO antibodies can be done. Okay. The other endocrine disturbances associated are Addison's disease, autoimmune polyglandular syndrome, pernicious anemia, rheumatoid arthritis. But remember, Crohn's disease and iron deficiency are not associated with vitiligo. Vitiligo vulgaris best treatment is psoralens with UVA, together called as PUVA. The other treatment modalities are steroids, Coalthar, clopidogrel, that is topical steroid, tacrolimus, calcineurin inhibitor, methoxsalen. Remember, there was one question where they have mentioned topical isotretinoin or something in the options, but retinoids are not at all used in vitiligo vulgaris. It has a genetic predisposition, vitiligo. Leukotrichia is associated with a bad prognosis. Generalized vitiligo is often symmetrical. Trauma and sunburn may precipitate vitiligo. Focal areas of melanocyte loss are observed. In one question, they have used different types of terms like melanocytes have been reduced and so on and so forth. But remember, it is melanocyte loss, not reduction. Okay. And in one more question, they have mentioned that child had presented with a white patch at birth. In the options, vitiligo was in the one of the options, but remember, vitiligo is not a congenital condition. MBH, mono benzyl ether of hydroquinone causes depigmentation of the skin. In fact, in patients who have almost generalized fashion of vitiligo with only islands of normal skin remaining, the treatment is MBEH, after which the patient will have completely depigmented skin from head to toe. There are certain drugs which can cause hyperpigmentation of the skin: dactinomycin, cyclophosphamide, chlorpromazine, clofazamine, chloroquine, busulfan. These are the drugs. Remember, one of the options, the thioestrogen was given. If the question repeats, remember it will not cause any hyperpigmentation. This was the question. Newborn with solitary white well-defined hyperpigmented patch on the left thigh. The answer is nevus acromicus. It's not piebaldism, because piebaldism, as we already discussed, it will present with white forelock. And albinism, there will be generalized hypopigmentation, depigmentation in fact. And acral vitiligo, it is not present congenitally, it will be acquired later on in the life. Hypopigmented lesion on the center of the forehead. And if you can see the patient clinically, you can ask the history of application of bindi. This actually is a proper question from dermatitis topic, where there is allergic conjunctivitis to paratertiary butylphenol, PTBP, paratertiary butylphenol. And a 23-year-old lady develops brown macular lesions over the bridge of the nose and cheeks, that is convexities, following exposure to sunlight, that is because of UV radiation. The diagnosis is, in the options, chloroma was present, but if melasma is there, then that is a better option, because chloroma is actually a specific term used for hyperpigmentation seen during pregnancy, but it is sometimes used as a synonymous with melasma, so it's fine to answer chloroma. Coming to acanthosis nigricans, it is most commonly seen in obese individuals, more commonly in the axilla. It signifies internal malignancy if it is present with elderly, so you must rule out any internal malignancies. It is associated with insulin resistance, as you all know. It is Hyrand syndrome, hyperandrogenism, insulin resistance, and acanthosis nigricans. It is associated with insulin resistance. And even they have asked what are the histopathological findings in acanthosis nigricans. There is papillomatosis, you remember this point. Diffuse form of hyperpigmentation is seen in vitamin B12 deficiency, Cushing syndrome, Graves disease, and Addison's disease. But remember, it is not hyperpigmentation which is seen in hypothyroidism. Hyperpigmentation in HIV patients is due to melanocyte stimulating hormone. Hyperpigmented lesions are seen in, of course, melanoma, you all know. Dyskeratosis congenita, lichen planus, Becker's nevus, nevus of aorta, nevus of aorta. All these conditions will have hyperpigmented lesions. And lichen planus I have discussed in papillosquamous disorders. The link for this video, I will provide it in the I button here. You can check that video. Becker's nevus, they will give a case explaining hyperpigmented macules with coarseness and growth of hair and presence of acne lesions. If this is present in the question, these are pointers toward the diagnosis of Becker's nevus. Mongolian spots is not a nevus of melanocytes, but it is a defect in migration of the melanocytes from the neural crest. Melanocytes are migrated from the neural crest, but if they are arrested during their process of journey at lower dermal level, then it will lead to Mongolian spots. Malignant transformation to melanoma is common in dysplastic nevus. And nevus of aorta, if it is present bilaterally, then it is given a name of nevus of Hori. Minocycline, this is a favorite question asked many a times. If it is given to a patient, if individuals are predisposed, then it will lead to hyperpigmented spots at the site of old acne lesions, and also blue-black pigmentation of the nails. And chronic arsenic poisoning. This is also an important question. Raindrop pigmentation is seen. Basal cell carcinoma can occur. Palmar hyperkeratosis can be noticed. Anemia is possible. Alopecia is also possible. But remember, hirsutism is not adverse effect due to chronic arsenic poisoning. It's not a clinical feature. It's in fact alopecia. Topical azelaic acid is used in hyperpigmentary disorder. Wherever there is hyperpigmentation, there azelaic acid is used. Topical hydroquinone is effective in melasma because the mechanism of action is because it is a tyrosinase inhibitor. Few syndromes associated with pigmentary disorder is Leopard syndrome, also known as multiple lentigene syndrome. It is allelic to Noonan syndrome. Cutaneous myxomas are seen in Carinus complex. Mentioned this because they have given in a question, all except are seen in Leopard syndrome. Okay, L stands for lentigens, as the name is multiple lentigen syndrome. E stands for ECG defects. O stands for ocular hypertelorism. P stands for pulmonary stenosis. A stands for abnormality of genitalia. R is retardation of growth. Sensory neural deafness, D. So this is the full form of the Leopard syndrome. And many a times Peutz-Jeghers syndrome has also been tested, where perioral mucocutaneous lentigens are present over the lips. And lastly, Sturge-Weber syndrome. It's a sporadic showing tram track calcification in the CNS with unilateral port wine stain and retardation, mental retardation, eye changes, glaucoma, and CNS epilepsy. So these are all the features which are seen in Sturge-Weber syndrome.